What happened in Delhi?
What happened is that we told the economists, the liberals all over the world that Indian democracy is quite robust. That is what has happened in Delhi. This whole propaganda that democracy is under threat and all that has been proved totally wrong. Indian electorate has given a verdict. We consider it as the maturity of the electorate. It decided to return Mr. Kejriwal once again. We will analyze, as far as our party is concerned, what probably did not work in our favor. Although I'm just saying it rhetorically that we will analyze. Actually, there is no need. Everybody in the audience knows what has gone wrong, what went wrong for us and all that. But still, that is an exercise that we have to undertake.
Interesting that you say that, you know, your loss has shown that democracy is alive and kicking. I don't know what the converse message would be, that if you won, democracy would be in danger.
You see, the whole propaganda about this whole campaign about democracy in danger in India is actually after we won the election only. After we won the parliament election, suddenly this new propaganda that, you know, somehow the policies of this government are leading to causing damage to the democratic fabric and all that has begun. Just as in our victory also, there are very interesting cases of the strength of Indian democracy. Mr. Kalikesh's state, same day, same voting, one person voted for Modi on one machine and local leader on the other machine. Look at the maturity of Indian electorate. Whether we win or we lose, we won in Maharashtra, could not form the government. Their electorate has decided in our favor, but I'm only saying that Indian electorate has become very mature and very calculative.
You know, interesting you brought up that example, because is this now the template that the BJP is staring at in the days to come? Desh ke liye Modi, Pradesh ke liye koi aur. Desh ke liye Modi ji, Pradesh ke liye Biju Janata Dal, Pradesh ke liye Aam Aadmi Party, Pradesh ke liye Shiv Sena, Pradesh ke liye, I sure hope not you will be thinking TMC, Kalikesh.
You know, it just speaks of the personal credibility that Mr. Narendra Modi has as an individual. I think, and Mr. Ram Madhav may not like it as much when I say it, I think the people's acceptance of Mr. Modi as a Prime Minister is far greater than the people's acceptance of BJP as a party or its policies. I think that's crystal clear. I think, in my opinion, at least in the case of Odisha, a large number of, especially Congress voters, voted for the BJP in Parliament, primarily because Narendra Modi was the Prime Minister Cabinet. And I think it's been proven across from then. Pretty much every state which has gone into polls after that, the BJP has lost. Some states before the general elections too. So unless the BJP shapes up its policies, it's going to be Pradesh mein koi aur.
You know, how much will you...
No. On a lighter note, many of the so-called BJP's policies are supported by BJD in the parliament. So these are all, we make public statements just for consumption. This is a very old argument about right from Vajpayee's times. Vajpayee is a right man in a wrong party. Used to be the propaganda then. Now we are trying to separate Modi and BJP. This is not a very, solid kind of political argument. BJP and Modi ji, we are all one and the same. Its policies, its programs are all decided by the leadership together. Having said it, here the actual point on which I also agree with Kalkesh is, when it comes to national politics, there is nobody to come anywhere near Prime Minister Modi in terms of popularity or in terms of the popular confidence. The same kind of situation we are facing in state after state, probably in Orissa. Our leadership could not come on par with the leadership of BJD there. Whereas in Maharashtra, together we fought. We secured the required majority there. There the people have reposed faith in the alliance. It's another matter, alliance could not reach the culmination of forming the government. So it's also coming down to the question of when it comes to a state, who is the leader, who can deliver, who can give me my benefits. Probably people are thinking on those lines. One of the messages could be that.
No, but that's fine. For India, that is Mr. Modi. But in the states, already your footprint has been halved. What happened in 2014 and 2019, yes, it was a hawa, but it was a Modi hawa. Till when will it continue? Haven't you reached saturation point, or aren't you afraid that at some point you will reach saturation?
You see, each state is different. As I said, I would sometimes feel that real hands-down victory, the last time that party enjoyed in states, was in Tripura in 2018. The subsequent elections somehow, with an honorable exception of Maharashtra, because there the alliance secured majority, in no other state could we secure majority. From that point of view, what you are saying is true. But then, there are states coming. We have a major test coming up in 2021, when states like Bengal go to polls, when states like Assam go to polls. Assam, we are in power, we are quite confident of retaining power there. Bengal is going to be the real battle royale, I would say, where we will try our best to, capture power there. Mamata Banerjee has been there in power for almost 15 years now. So each state is different. But the point remains that you need to have good leadership as one of the ingredients, not necessarily the only ingredient.
So is the lack of a solid state leadership the reason why allies are also losing trust? Is that what happened in Maharashtra?
So in Maharashtra, as far as alliances are concerned, because he kept repeating Maharashtra and gave Maharashtra's example that BJP won the state, BJP did not win the state. That's exactly the problem. BJP won it in an alliance. Mm. And the minute you start discounting your alliance partner, that's when you start seeing issues. And Maharashtra was a significant game changer as far as that is concerned, where an alliance partner decided that enough was enough, and for the Bharatiya Janata Party to claim it as their victory and just talk about its own agenda does not work.
Do you think that's arrogance?
Absolute arrogance and an attitude of, everyone else is dispensable. Mm. Their contribution is dispensable. Their significance is not as much as they, as much as the political party would like to believe. So they need to realign their own ideas of themselves first, the Bharatiya Janata Party, and state after state is showing you the same thing. Mm. That people, of course, I continue to say this, that it is not, Mr. Modi is not in power because there is no alternative. He is in power because he continues to be extremely popular in the minds of the people. Mm. So even if he brings in some policies which will not go down well with the electorate, he will continue to get votes only because of his own personal credibility, and I quite concur with Kalikesh. Mm. But in terms of state governance, it becomes an issue about local governance, about local issues, whether it is about employment. You cannot keep winning at the back of Shri Narendra Modi's credibility. Mm. You have to have state leadership and your alliance, whichever pre-poll alliances that you come up with or post-poll alliances, you need to give them the dignity and the respect that you have won this alliance. It is the alliance which won the mandate, not just your party.
So as a semi-alliance partner of the BJP, you agree that in the states, it's this arrogance that makes parties wary?
I'd say an erstwhile alliance partner, not a semi-alliance partner. No, but see, Mr. Ram Madhav was a very affable, amicable gentleman. I wish his party was more like him. The problem with projecting an individual to gain all the credit of an entire political system, which is prevalent in every party, not just in the BJP today, it was in the Congress of the Gandhis and pretty much every regional party, including Priyanka's, with the Thackerays there. What happens is that when you give that individual all the credit for an entire system of administration, a massive system under you, the moment that individual falters or something goes against him, the entire edifice of the political system crumbles. I am not for that. Personally, I am not for over-centralization. I am more for a democratic sort of a system. But in India, that doesn't work. That's not the system. We are an executive-driven political system. The Prime Minister runs the political party as well as the government. Individual legislators have very little voice. And similarly for chief ministers in various states. So I think the BJP is going to come across a quandary where they suddenly realize that Mr. Modi's shine is not that shiny any longer. What do they do?
So it almost seems to be implied, Mr. Ram Madhav, that Mr. Modi is winning now despite the BJP and not because of the BJP.
Come on.
Or rather, you are winning because of Mr. Modi.
You know, this is one trend that you notice across the political spectrum in the country. In fact, he himself was saying that it's not limited to BJP alone, that leader-centric politics is not limited to BJP alone. Today, probably it is working for many parties. What was the Delhi result? It was for Mr. Kejriwal. It was for his governance.
But he was the center. It's a regional party. For a national party, say like the Congress, they've got regional satraps.
So what I'm trying to say is, we have now moved into a new kind of politics. We know that for similar kind of politics, Congress has paid a heavy price today in the form of collapse of the party organization altogether. We should be careful as a party, which we are. It is our responsibility that while we take great pride in our leadership and reap full advantage of that popularity of that leadership, we should not lose sight of the fact that you need to, down the line, build leaders who are credible, who are strong, who have the support of the masses at the state level. That we need to do. You see, as far as Maharashtra is concerned, this arrogance and all, you will call us arrogant, we will call you arrogant, it goes on. The fact remains, we fought the election together. We were supposed to form the government together. We could not arrive at an agreement. Fair enough. In democracy, it is allowed. Three failed students also can come together and have more marks than the first class student. It works in democracies. Fair enough, but then that cannot be shown as a virtue. You cannot show it as your virtue. It's not. It's a simple electoral arithmetic which you used claim something, but we will see. I mean, these are all,
But you've done it in states. That's how you are in plenty of states.
No, it's arithmetic when others do it, and it's democracy at work when
No, I'm not saying. I'm only saying, why do you call arrogant? Then you are also arrogant.
No.
Don't call arrogant. Okay, arithmetic you use in your favor. We did it in some states.
You didn't go.
That's what I'm saying. In politics, democracy allows that. You allow that in a democratic way, you do that. That is what they did in Maharashtra.
When you say this, when you say three failed students got together, that is when you're accused of being arrogant.
No, we, in those states like Goa, we are the largest party. We are not a failed student. No. We are the largest party there. Whereas by any stretch, Shiv Sena cannot claim to be the largest party. Still, I'm saying, arithmetic is in their favor. They have a right to run the government, which we are accepting. Who is contesting that?
Do you have enough regional leaders, or has a big central leadership, jisko kehte hain ki bargat ki chhaon mein kuch ugta nahi hai. So has the regional leadership shriveled away?
You see, our chief ministers, several of them have become former chief ministers now. They were all very strong local leaders. Whether it is former chief minister of Maharashtra or former chief minister of Madhya Pradesh, young by political standards. Real young means something else, but in our system, even you are reaching 50, still you are a young leader. So in that sense, we have good young chief ministers who have become former chief ministers in states. We have good leaders in states. Yet we have lost. See, Madhya Pradesh, tell me, didn't we have a good local leadership? We had local leadership. Yet we lost that election. See, that is where number of other factors also come in. That's what I'm saying. Leader is one ingredient, one element that you need to have. But that's not alone. Congress has very good leaders in many states. They can never aspire to come back in those states.
Okay, so there is no perfect formula. I am being told that we are racing against the clock. So we have to wrap up now. But thank you very much, both gentlemen and Priyanka Chaturvedi, for having joined me. But I really wish we had more time because, with state elections, 4-5 states going to polls in the next 2 years, it would be very interesting to see how you are going to actually recover from this talent deficit, as many people are calling it. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you all for that. And Padmaja, you can come right back. We're going to be sticking to the subject of state elections for our next discussion as well, about whether the invocation of national issues have any serious resonance with the electorate as they vote at the legislative assembly level or not. We're going to be grateful that the Union Minister for Information and Broadcasting and Environment, Forests and Climate Change, Mr. Prakash Javadekar, has joined us today to speak about exactly this. And he's going to be in a fireside chat. When I say fireside, no pun intended.